Hi viewer, I welcome you to Rim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 3, Lesson 24. The topic is lakes. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today, we are going to define the lake. We look at the factors that determine the permanency of the lake. We look at the reasons why some lakes are saline. And now, we also look at the formation and the classification of lakes. So, by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to define lake, to state the factors that determine the permanency of the lake, to state the reasons why some lakes are saline, and also to highlight how the lakes are formed. We start by definition. When we are defining lake, we have a lake is a hollow depression or basin on the earth's surface in which water has accumulated. So it might be a basin, it might be a crater, or even a depression, but there must be the presence of water that has accumulated in that place. Where does this water that accumulates in lakes comes from? It comes from the rainfall. This is the rainfall that falls. We also have the rivers. We also have the underground water and also the melting of the ice. What are the factors that determine the permanency of the lake? One, we have availability of water that is drained into the basin from the sources. So the availability of water, is it readily available? If at all it is the permanent rivers that are feeding the lake, then it means that that lake will be permanent. But if at all they are semi-permanent rivers or seasonal rivers, that lake will be semi-permanent. Then number two, it is the nature of underlying rocks. This is by looking at the non-porous rocks and porous rocks. For the non-porous rocks, they limit water loss through seepage, as it is compared to the porous rocks. So because it limits, it means that water that has been accumulated in the basin will stay there for a long time compared to the porous rocks that will allow the seepage, so draining of the lake. Then the third one, it is the rate of evaporation. When we talk about the rate of evaporation, that is the loss of water in the atmosphere from the lake. And number four, it is the human activities. Human activities meaning what kind of activities the human doing using this water that is coming from the lake. Excessive agricultural activity reduces the volume of the lake. Sometimes it can dry. Now, lakes may be salty or fresh water. Let us see the reason as to why. Some lakes are saline or salty. One, we have the absence or lack of the outlet to drain out the excess salts. So there is no outlet. It has only the inlet. Some lack enough fresh waters, rivers that drain water into them. So they are only fed by the underground water. And this underground water, remember, it contains the salt. Three, some lakes are located in arid areas where high evaporation rate is there. So making the water saltiness concentration up. Four, the bed of the lake may comprise of soluble rock with the mineral salts which dissolve in the water. Five, surface runoff and rivers may dissolve a lot of salt from the rocks on which they are framed in case the surface, the rocks be soluble in water. Now, let us look at the formation of and classification of wrecks. Wrecks are classified according to the way they are formed. So that is the reason as to why we combine the two. Wrecks are classified according to their mode of formation. There are these classes. Tectonic movement wrecks. We refer to them as tectonic wrecks. And these ones, they are formed when now we have the tectonic movements. They are those rocks that are formed through volcanic activity. And we refer to them as the volcanic wrecks. They are those that are formed by glaciation. They are those that are formed by deposition and others erosion, others from the human activities. Let us see the first one, the faulted wrecks. These are the from the tectonic forces, the faulted wrecks. Deeply faulted areas forms along narrow depressions, hollows, which are filled with water to form lake. They cross Lake Turkana, Lake Barigo, Lake Bogoria, and Nakuru. You can see faulting, the earth movement by the tension and compression. Wrecks formed by the crustal warping and down warping. That is up warping and down warping. Internal land forming processes result into down warping and up warping. The down warping forms the depression that are later filled with water. And examples of this one, we have Lake Kyoga, Lake Victoria. These are the wrecks that are formed by the tectonic movements. That is what we have already done. Then that is the kind of the wreck. And an example, we have Lake George, which is in the Rift Valley. Then number two, we have those wrecks that are formed as a result of volcanic activity. We have the crater wrecks and the caldera wrecks. They are wrecks that are formed when the water fill the crater and the caldera formed through volcanic activity. They cross the wreck paradise. This is at Mount Matsabit. We also have the Nkoga, which is at Meru, Shara, which is at Ethiopia. Then we have the lava dammed lakes. They are formed when flowing lava broke sections of the river areas where water can accumulate. They cross the Mutada. We also have Lake Itase. All those ones now, they are there. You can see the crater lakes that we have. Activity define lake. State for reasons why some lake are salty. For reference, you can get the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 3, Third Edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us through SMSing us. You can also get us through the YouTube, get us through the Facebook, and also you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Erin TV. Thank you.